Have a nice day, everyone. Please, before we get into the video, if you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe and leave a like, as well as watch the video till the end, as it will really help the channel and help me make more contents for you. Also, you can leave any suggestions for future videos in the comments below. Thank you very much. In this video, I will speak about some notes about how to depart, how to prepare aircraft for revenue flight. Revenue means paid. I will take money from this flight, not ferry. Okay? About ground equipment arrangements also. Here is this page from this manual. Okay, look here. This is the aircraft, the fuselage, the left wing, right wing, tail, engine, left engine, right engine, or engine number one, engine number two. Okay, here at the forward is the towing vehicle and towing bar, okay, to make push back or move the aircraft from the stand to begin the runway. Take care here, the right side here, right side, the surfaces. The left side for passenger. Look here, this is the gate, the passenger. This is the door, left door, forward left door. Okay, here also the aft left door. Here is the surfacing for, take care here, for serviceable for water or toilet. Okay, and here also at the right here, look here, this is the cargo door, cargo compartment. Here is the baggage or luggage. Also here, here is the bulk cargo door, bulk compartment for cargo. Okay. And here is galley, galley services, means the catering for passenger meal. Also here, servicing for the galley. Here is the ground power unit. Okay. I will show you some details here. While I make the BDC pre-departure check, must check here that the chocks here are installed here. Okay, and before taxiing, you must remove these chocks. Here is the ground power unit. If you don't operate the APU, the auxiliary power unit, so you will need ground power unit for external power. Okay, the panel according to the aircraft, maybe here, according to the engine, the aircraft type. Okay? My notes here, don't put the ground power unit perpendicular to the fuselage, but put it parallel to the fuselage. Why? If any movement here, any error movement, will stuck in the fuselage and make damage or scratch or, okay? The second thing, this is the air conditioning vehicle. Also, if you don't operate the APU, you will need the air conditioning. Okay, also make it parallel to the fuselage. By the way, here, what is the distance between the fuselage and the ground power unit? How many meters? How many feet? I think the safety distance is 3 meters. 3 meters between the ground power unit and the fuselage. Here, this is the fueling truck to refuel the aircraft. Also, take care here. This is here parallel to the fuselage, not perpendicular, but parallel. Okay? For the risk. If any movement when this vehicle is perpendicular, maybe damage the fuselage. Here is the catering, the meals for the passenger. Here, okay, and the aft and forward of the fuselage. Here, if the aircraft far away of the gate and stand, so you need this stair and the passenger will go here. Okay? Here, the sick people, passenger, come here, look here, this sign, here, okay, to save these people. Here, look here, this is the right side, the cargo compartment here, the forward, and this is the luggage or bags, and this is the belt here. Take care for here, the touch of the belt and the door. At the end, after fueling and passenger on the cabin, and the pilot comes on, and the crew and the maintenance make the BDC. Now, the aircraft can go to flight. So I want to move it. This is the towing vehicle and this is the towing bar. Okay. This is the towing bar. It's according to the aircraft type. Okay. Here, this is the bin of the steering, the nose steering by bus. Here, during taxi, during towing, must put this bin, and after the towing finished, you must remove this. Okay? Also, this is the lock bins for the gear, nose and mains. This is just for example for 737 Okay, but each aircraft type has its look bands. Okay, thank you very much and goodbye.